So I completed a Bachelor of Science degree in astronomy in 2020, and I found that pretty much most people have no idea what astronomy really is. And in many cases, they think that I'm talking about astrology, or they just forget the name astronomy. And they call it astrology. And then I'll correct them and be like, "Oh, actually, it's astronomy." And so they'll be like, "Oh, right, astronomy." But inevitably, I'll be in a conversation and the topic of space will come up, and someone will be like, "Oh, Morgan knows a lot about astrology." So cringe. So just to make sure we're on the same page here, astrology is very basically a pseudoscience that people practice by looking at the relative locations of celestial objects and using those to, I guess, kind of predict things about people and society. Now, that's how I understand it, but I realize I could be a little bit off, so please do not come for me if that's the case. Astronomy, on the other hand, is a physical science which combines basically every other science, but mostly physics plus mathematics, in order to study literally everything outside of Earth's atmosphere. So that could be like the sun, planets, galaxies, black holes, nebulae, etc. So the first thing to know if you're going to major in astronomy is that basically no one is going to know what that means. And you're going to have to literally force yourself to not visibly cringe every time someone thinks it's astrology or calls it astrology. Now that we've got that straight, we can start looking at the major itself. So, space is really cool, right? That means that a lot of people will take Astronomy 100, 101, or whatever is the introductory class for non-majors. Now, I did this because I was already majoring in economics, but I thought space was super cool. And later on, I decided to major in astronomy as well. So, having taken the introductory astronomy courses for majors, I saw that there was a pretty significant difference in difficulty level between the intro classes for non-majors and those for majors. So, the second thing to know if you're going to major in astronomy is that people may tell you, or you may hear, that astronomy is easy. Now, that's almost like saying that physics is easy, which I feel like no one has ever said, unless there's some kind of next level genius. So, what I'm trying to say here is that astronomy is not an easy major. Now, let's look at what a college astronomy curriculum may look like so that you can have an accurate understanding of what the major entails. So, I went to the University of Maryland, so I'll explain that curriculum first, and then I'll go a little into how it may be different at other universities. The astronomy classes that you have to take for the astronomy major at the University of Maryland are an introduction to astrophysics of the solar system, an introduction to the astrophysics of everything outside the solar system, observational astronomy, theoretical astrophysics, and any two advanced electives selected from stellar structure and evolution, radio astronomy, computational astrophysics, galaxies, cosmology, the solar system, astrophysics of exoplanets, orbital dynamics, and high energy astrophysics. The math courses you'll have to take are calculus 1 through 3, linear algebra, and differential equations. The physics courses you need to take are mechanics and relativity, fields, waves, modern physics, quantum physics, statistical thermodynamics, and a sequence of 3 labs, one introduction, one on mechanics and heat, and one on electricity and magnetism. And lastly, Astronomy majors need to take a course on programming for the physical sciences, which for me was taught in Python. Now, based on some research I did loosely, other schools offering a Bachelor of Science degree may require one or two more or one or two different physics classes. They may require that you complete some kind of undergraduate project or thesis. They basically all require some kind of programming and/or data analysis course, and the required astronomy and math courses seem to be more or less the same from university to university. Now, you may be thinking that astronomy would be a good subject to double major in or add a minor or minors to, and you would be absolutely correct about that. The double major that makes the most sense to me and that a lot of people end up going for is physics because, like, at least half of the an astronomy BS is physics. So, if you're thinking about grad school or you really enjoy physics as well as astronomy, double majoring is a great way to go. Now, I don't think I would necessarily recommend double majoring in anything other than physics, but if you really want to, obviously you could do so. Really, the only other ones that I'm thinking of right now that would make any kind of sense are computer science, mathematics, and statistics, but each of those are difficult as well, and they don't overlap with astronomy as much as physics does. So, undertaking these double majors would likely take you more than 4 years, which may not be ideal depending on who you are. Now, some minors that would be good, in my opinion, are physics, computer science, mathematics, statistics, English or writing, or just something that you enjoy. I think I've covered everything I'm able to speak on, having only completed a Bachelor of Science degree in astronomy as of now. So, I hope you learned something about majoring in astronomy as an undergrad. Thank you so much for watching. Toss me a like if you enjoyed it, and I'll see you next time.